A and IS level mathematics. Lesson 20. We're going to be looking at surds. And we're going to be looking at what is a surd. Rules for manipulation of surds, including rationalising the denominator. So let's start with what is a surd. But before we can do that, we need to talk about rational numbers and irrational numbers. There's several definitions of rational numbers. One of them is that rational numbers can be plotted on a number line. A better one is that rational numbers can be written as P over Q, where P and Q are integers, in other words, whole numbers. So rational numbers would include all your whole numbers, both positive and negative, because all of those you could write over one and then make them look like a fraction. Obviously, it includes the fractions, and it includes the decimals, because they can then be written as fractions. And recurring decimals, any recurring decimal can also be written as a fraction. And mixed numbers, they can be written as fractions. So all numbers that can be written as a fraction with a whole number over a whole number. And of course all of these can then be plotted on a number line. An irrational number is a number that can't be plotted on a number line, such as a non-terminating, non-recurring decimal. Pi is a very good example, because if you try to change that to a decimal, you'll find that it doesn't actually recur, and it doesn't actually ever stop. So that's an irrational number. Or the square root of a non-perfect square. That you can't work out. It's a decimal, 1 point in this case, but it never recurs and never repeats. Or the cube root of a non-perfect cube. Let's put 11 there. So, irrational numbers are non-terminating, non-recurring decimals, and you can't plot them on the number line. So, as far as surds are concerned, originally, the definition of a surd was the same as an irrational number. In other words, it cannot be expressed in this way. But with time, it was discovered that this is not a very good definition. In fact, the mathematicians can't exactly decide what a surd is. So if they can't, I'm not going to either. But basically, we think of it as being the square root of a non-perfect square. So if you put a non-perfect square inside there, you've got a surd. It doesn't matter if you've got another number there, which is a whole number, or another number there, which is a whole number. The square root of a non-perfect square will be a surd. At least that's the definition we're going to go for. So let's look at manipulating surds. First off, addition and subtraction. A little bit of algebra. If we do A plus A, we get 2A. Or 2b plus 3b, we get 5b. Well, we can deal with surds in an extremely similar way. The root of 6, the square root of 6, plus the square root of 6, gives me 2 square root of 6s. 3 square root of 6s plus 5 square root of 6s will give me altogether 8 square root of 6s. Same thing for subtraction. 8 square root of 7s minus 6 square root of 7s will leave me with just 2 square root of 7s. 12 square root of 3s minus 7 square root of 3s will leave me with 5 square root of 3s. But, as with ordinary algebra, you can't add or subtract if they're not what we call like terms. So 2p plus 3q would be 2p plus 3q. Or 2p minus 3q would be 2p minus 3q. Same applies to our surds. 2 root of 7 add on 3 root of 5 would be 2 root of 7 plus 3 root of 5. Although, later we might find that some of these we can simplify even if we're not strictly adding or subtracting. Now let's look at multiplication of surds, manipulating surds, multiplying. The square root of 6 multiplied by the square root of 6 can be written as the square root of 6 multiplied by 6, which is therefore the square root of 36, which is therefore 6. The square root of 7 multiplied by the square root of 7 is the same as the square root of 7 multiplied by 7, which is therefore the square root of 49, which is therefore 7. So the root of a number multiplied by the root of the same number would in fact be that number. Now what about if the two numbers inside the square root signs aren't the same? The square root of 3 multiplied by the square root of 12 will be the square root of 3 multiplied by 12, which is therefore the square root of 36. So we can in fact see that if you multiply a surd that cannot be calculated, because it's a non-recurring, non-terminating decimal, by another surd, which is the square root of a non-perfect square, which is therefore a non-terminating, non-recurring decimal. But we could end up multiplying them together and find they actually work out to a nice simple number. Let's have a look at this one. The square root of 32 multiplied by the square root of 2 is the square root of 32 multiplied by 2. And 2 32s are 64, and that's a perfect square, so we could actually work this out. Or another way we could say we can simplify it. So if we have 3 root 5s multiplied by 5 root 6s, we can have 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by the square root of 5 multiplied by 6. So that gives me 15 multiplied by the root of 30. Let's look at that one on this case. 4 root 2 multiplied by 6 square root of 8. Doesn't matter if I say root or square root of, it means the same thing. 4 square root of 2 multiplied by 6 square root of 8. We can do the 4 times the 6. And then we can look at the square root of 2 multiplied by the square root of 8. And then we can appreciate that this is, in fact, the square root of 16, which we can work out. So this one will end up as 4 times 6, which is 24, and then 4 24s, which is 96. So in fact, something like that, in certain circumstances, can simplify down to, well, something that looks nice and simple. Let's manipulate surds by division. So we can always write something divided by something as a fraction. 24, the square root of 24 divided by the square root of 8. But then we can write that as the square root of 24 over 8. We can put the square root sign around the whole thing. This may cancel, in this case it does. So this simplifies to this. Let's look at another example. The square root of 24 divided by the square root of 6 can be written like that. That can be written like that. That will cancel because there's 4 sixes in 24, and then that will could be worked out. Square root of 4 is 2.